Welcome to Cases of Mistaken Identity. These tutorials are based on real questions asked by my medical and dental students over the years. Case 4. Is this a nerve or what? I'm Dr. Catherine Moore, the histology wizard. Students often mix up peripheral nerve with smooth muscle and dense irregular connective tissue. Let's investigate. In routine H&E slides, peripheral nerves do resemble these other fibrous tissues, particularly in longitudinal sections. All three tissues are eosinophilic and they all contain scattered elongated nuclei. So without other clues such as location in the body or recognizable features such as erythrocytes in a blood vessel, identification isn't always easy. But there are several things that may help you tell these tissues apart. Number one is the general appearance of the tissue fibers. Number two, the location and number of nuclei. And number three, color. Now, color is not something that I will generally tell my students to use as a distinguishing feature, but in this case, color, or maybe intensity, can be helpful. So let's start by looking at peripheral nerve. Here are a couple of peripheral nerves cut in longitudinal section. First thing to note is that this nervous tissue is wavy, even in transverse section, and in the enteric ganglia. Why wavy? Well, you are looking at a nerve bundle full of individual myelinated axons. The way I think about this is if we took a bunch of electrical cords and we bound them somewhat loosely together. They tend to sort of twist together, but they don't exactly line up in perfectly straight lines. So when we section peripheral nerve, we see waves and sometimes even white spaces between the bundles. Peripheral nerve is almost always the palest staining of the three tissues, and it has a frothy, almost foamy appearance. This is because myelin, which is mostly fat, and axoplasm, which is mostly water, don't stain well with common stains, and also because myelin can be removed by the fixation process, leaving almost clear spaces. Peripheral nerve sections show numerous nuclei, but remember, the visible nuclei mostly belong to Schwann cells. These are external nuclei. They lie alongside the associated fibers, not within them. In a ganglion where the axons are smaller and unmyelinated, the nuclei are likely to be fibroblasts or other glia. Finally, peripheral nerve has a connective tissue sheath that's called the perineurium, and this is lacking in smooth muscle and dense irregular connective tissue. Peripheral nerve also has few to no blood vessels. Now let's compare to smooth muscle. Smooth muscle cells have unbranched, snug, almost parallel fibers. A small, smooth muscle bundle can resemble peripheral nerve, but it lacks that connective tissue sheath or perineurium. Smooth muscle cells have very characteristic S or cigar-shaped nuclei, and unlike peripheral nerve nuclei, they are internal to the fibers. So you can see that best in the transverse section on the right. In terms of number of nuclei, smooth muscle has fewer nuclei than peripheral nerve and more nuclei than dense irregular connective tissue. Smooth muscle almost always stains more intensely than peripheral nerve. It's often, as you see here, a dark magenta pink color in an H&E stain. Now here's an exception. This is smooth muscle in the tunica media of an artery. In this case, we're looking at the location, the shape, the lack of a perineurium, and the presence of erythrocytes to provide the clues that tell us that this is smooth muscle and not peripheral nerve. Now, what about dense irregular connective tissue? Well, the most obvious characteristic of this tissue is the thick, ropey collagen fibers that are variable in both size and direction. And you can really appreciate that in this higher magnification. Dense irregular connective tissue also has the fewest visible nuclei that lie external to those collagen fibers. And the tissue often appears more red-orange than pink, although this is not always true. In this section of dermis, for example, we see that the tissue is staining a very pale pink, but we see irregular fibers, a lack of abundant nuclei, and abundant blood vessels, and this marks this tissue as dense irregular connective tissue. To compare, let's look at some sections that have all three tissues. Here in these two sections from the duodenum, I hope that you can now appreciate the wavy, pale nervous tissue, the parallel fibers of the smooth muscle, which stains quite darkly, and the many irregular collagen fibers of the dense irregular connective tissue. Remember also that, generally speaking, smooth muscle will stain the most intensely, while dense irregular connective tissue has the fewest number of nuclei. I hope that these tips will help you solve this case of mistaken identity. Thanks for stopping by.